This is a sneak peek at a new edge infrastructure solution under development by Microsoft Azure. In this video, we'll see how this new edge infrastructure is provisioned from the cloud, how it's fully managed from the cloud, its minimal footprint that's optimized for edge devices, that it runs the full Azure Kubernetes service enabled by Azure Arc, and how it can deliver enterprise-grade availability with multiple nodes. Let's get started with provisioning. With this new infrastructure, there's no local machine setup needed. Instead, we use the industry standard FIDO Device Onboard, or FDO, mechanism to perform initial machine provisioning from the cloud. Here's how it works. When a new device first arrives, simply plug in power and get it on the network. The device comes pre-imaged with a minimal FDO agent whose only job is to automatically connect to the cloud and wait to be claimed. The solution vendor provides an ownership voucher, which can be entered into the Azure portal to claim the device, which finally enables you to deploy and configure the software you want. Let's take a look. In Azure Arc, I'll navigate to Provisioning, and then Provision a New Device. Here I can provide, among other things, the ownership voucher, and then make selections, like choosing which operating system to install. Once I've provisioned my new device or devices, I can create a new edge infrastructure instance. For example, maybe it's a new factory location, and select one or multiple devices to deploy to. This can be done through the Azure portal or just as well through an Azure Resource Manager or ARM template so that it's repeatable at scale across hundreds or thousands of locations. Cloud-based management enables you to centrally operate many distributed locations. Here, in Azure Arc, I see the infrastructure I've deployed to my factory locations around the world, all in a single pane of glass. I can select an instance to drill into and get additional details. Now, this experience is still in development, but I can see a few things, like that this is a three-node infrastructure. And in fact, if I navigate to Machines in the left menu, I can see those three nodes. They're all connected, and I can see details like cores, memory, and operating system. Now's a good time to talk about footprint. For this tech demo, the hardware we're using is Lenovo ThinkEdge SE30. These things are great. They're rugged, they're inexpensive, but they're pretty small. Each machine has just 4 cores and 16 gigs of memory. That turns out to be plenty. To make the most of limited resources, this new infrastructure uses the Azure Linux operating system directly on the physical machines, and then the Azure Kubernetes service to turn those machines into a Kubernetes cluster. To be clear, this means Kubernetes is running directly on bare metal. There's no virtualization. The whole solution is then connected back to Azure Arc for management. This approach is very efficient. In the portal, we can go to Metrics, and then take a look at memory utilization, split by node name. Look at this. It's hovering around or below 25% on each node. That means the vast majority of memory remains available for workloads. Speaking of workloads, this new infrastructure runs the full Azure Kubernetes service enabled by Azure Arc. In the portal, in the left menu under Kubernetes, we can see the cluster itself and navigate to it. Here, I have access to all the management capabilities available with Azure Arc, like, for example, GitOps integration. I can also dig in and see the pods and other resources that are running on the Kubernetes cluster. For this demo, I've deployed a sample app called Azure Voting App. It's pretty simple. There's a front end, a back end, and it just serves up this web page that lets you vote about which is better, cats or dogs. Simple as it is, we can use this app to test out how this new infrastructure provides high availability. What happens if the machine where the voting app front end is running fails unexpectedly? Let's try it. If we refresh the page, we see it no longer loads. The app is down. But this only lasts for a minute. Detecting that node 2 is down, Kubernetes will terminate the pod and then redeploy it promptly and automatically to another node that's up, like node 3. If we refresh again, ta-da! The app is back. No user intervention required. This capability to cluster multiple nodes and provide local HA is a must-have for so many applications at the edge. To learn more about this new solution for edge devices being developed by Microsoft Azure, and to sign up for the preview that's coming soon, visit the Azure Stack blog. Thanks for watching!